Hello friends, this video is about what is spoil system in politics or political science. In politics and government, a spoil system, also known as patronage system, is a practice in which a political party, after winning an election, gives government civil service jobs to its supporters, friends and relatives as a reward for working toward victory and as an incentive to keep working for the party, as opposed to a merit system where offices are awarded on the basis of some measures of merit independent of political activity. The term was used particularly in politics of the United States, where the federal government operated on a spoil system until the Pendleton Act was passed in 1883 due to a civil service reform movement. Thereafter, the spoil system was largely replaced by non-patronage merit at the federal level of the United States. The term was derived from the phrase "to the victor belong the spoils" by New York Senator William M. Marcy, referring to the victory of Andrew Jackson in the election of 1828, with the term spoil meaning goods or benefits taken from the loser in a capitation election or military victory. Similar spoil systems are common in other nations that traditionally have been based on tribal organization or other kinship groups and localism in general. Origins. Before 1892, modernization had prevailed in the transfer of political power from one U.S. president to another. Andrew Jackson's first inauguration, March 4, 1829, signaled a sharp departure from the past. A group of office seekers attended the event, explaining it as democratic enthusiasm. Jackson supporters had been lavished with promises of positions in return for political support. These promises were honored by a large number of removals after Jackson assumed power. At the beginning of Jackson's administration, fully 919 officials were removed from government positions, amounting to nearly 10% of all government postings. The Jackson administration aimed at creating a more efficient system where the chain of command of public employees all obeyed the higher entities of government. The hardship change organization within the federal government proved to be the post office. The post office was the largest department in the federal government and had even more personnel than the war department. In 1 year, 423 postmasters were deprived of their positions, most with extensive records of good service. Reform. By the late 1860s, citizens began demanding civil service reform, running under the Liberal Republican Party in 1872. They were soundly defeated by Ulysses S. Grant. After the assassination of James A. Garfield by a rejected office seeker in 1881, the calls for civil service reform intensified. Moderation of the spoil system at the federal level came with the passage of the Pendleton Act in 1883, which created a bipartisan civil service commission to evaluate job candidates on a non-partisan merit basis. While few jobs were covered under the law initially, the law allowed the president to transfer jobs and their current holders into the system, thus giving the holder a permanent job. The Pendleton Act's reach was expanded as the two main political parties alternated control of the White House every election between 1884 and 1896. Following each election, the outgoing president applied the Pendleton Act to some of the positions he had 8.8 political supporters too. By 1900, most feudal jobs were handled through civil service, and the spoil system was limited to fewer and fewer positions. Although state patronage systems and numerous feudal positions were unaffected by the law, Carbell urged that the Pendleton Act was instrumental in the creation of a professional civil service and the rise of the modern bureaucratic state. The law also caused major changes in campaign finance as the parties were forced to look for new sources of campaign funds, such as wealthy donors. The separation between the political activity and the civil service was made stronger with the Hatch Act of 1939, which prohibited feudal employees from engaging in many political activities. The spoil system survived much longer in many states, counties, and municipalities, such as the Tammany Hall machine, which survived until the 1950s, when New York City reformed its own civil service. Illinois modernized its bureaucracy in 1917 under Frank Loudoun, but Chicago held on to patronage in city government until the city agreed to end the practice in the Shakeman decrees of 1972 and 1980.